The NHL is like any other sports league. There are some teams that people hate more than others. And if you're a true fan of the sport, there's a team you have to despise. Otherwise, you just aren't living the sports fan life right. The NHL is different, however. MLB will always feature the New York Yankees as its most hated team. The NFL will have the Dallas Cowboys and New England Patriots take that honor. In the NBA, it'll always be the Boston Celtics and Los Angeles Lakers. In the NHL, the most hated teams can change every few years. But as of right now, we'll count it down. I'm Justin Fraction, and today we bring to you the 10 most hated NHL teams. Number 10, Detroit Red Wings. Everyone respects the heck out of the owner, Mike Ilitch, GM Ken Holland, and their consistency. They've made the playoffs every year since the 1990-91 season and have done 4 Stanley Cups along with 2 other Eastern Conference championships. Not to mention their President's Trophies in 96, 2002, 2004, 2006, and 2008. The Red Wings basically just always win and have diminished the entire league throughout the years to reach the very top. As great as they are, how can a non-Wings fan actually love them? They've dashed your team's dreams, so you surely hate them in a way. Number 9, Edmonton Oilers. There are a few reasons to hate the Oilers. Just how many hearts did they break from 1980 through 1990? Their dynasty years led by Wayne Gretzky culminated in 5 Stanley Cup championships. They dominated the league and rule changes were needed to keep them out, such as coincidental minors being taken away for a brief period of time. They also have developed fierce rivalries with the Western Canadian teams, the Vancouver Canucks and Calgary Flames. Oh, but how about the fact they seemingly win the draft lottery every year but never turn these guys into stars? Gets kind of tiring for 29 other teams and its fans, doesn't it? Number 8, Philadelphia Flyers. During the 1970s, the Broad Street Bullies used their mean nature and toughness to terrorize the league and win 2 Stanley Cups. The Flyers have had a number of punks and classless players throughout the years, Daniel Carcillo, Chris Pronger, and Zach Rinaldo, just to name a few. They also try to be like the New York Yankees by throwing money at every good free agent. Oh, and Flyers sports fans are totally obnoxious. For example, chanting "She said no" to Patrick Kane, who was cleared of rape accusations, is a douchey move. Number 7, Chicago Blackhawks. There haven't been many dynasties like the Hawks of the 2010s that have deserved and earned so much respect. A team that keeps replacing old stars with new ones and winning with classy players makes them a good model organization. That being said, they did have goons Andrew Ladd, Dustin Byfuglien, and Dave Boland carry them to some of their championships. Also, Duncan Keith, their star blue liner, has delivered a number of cheap shots. Oh, and Patrick Kane beat up a cab driver for not having a few cents in change. That's a jerk move. Some of the acts from these guys make the Hawks easy to hate for some. Number 6, Montreal Canadiens. People will hate you when you have 24 Stanley Cups, but the Habs have always found ways to draw hatred. Never mind that they have fierce rivalries with Detroit, Ottawa, and Toronto. Remember their riots in the 50s because Maurice Richard was suspended? Or when fans wanted police to investigate Zdeno Chara for his ugly hit on Max Pacioretty? The Habs have had some pesky players like Mike Ribeiro, Dale Weiss, and P.K. Subban over the years. Easy for people to hate you in those cases. Number 5, Los Angeles Kings. Toronto Maple Leafs fans will always hate the Kings for their somewhat unfair win in the playoffs in 1993. Wayne Gretzky's no-call high stick on Doug Gilmour cost the Leafs a chance at the Stanley Cup, and they're waiting to win it all again. But the Kings have been hated since winning the Cup in 2012. Dustin Brown is one of the biggest trolls with hits and excellent defense. Milan Lucic was one big goon and bully with them as well. The Kings have harsh rivalries with San Jose and Anaheim, but also the Vancouver Canucks and Chicago Blackhawks. As such, millions of fans from some of the better teams just hate them. Number 4, Pittsburgh Penguins. Congrats to the Penguins on their 2016 Stanley Cup championship, but still their rivalries with both the Islanders and Rangers in New York, plus the Washington Capitals and Philadelphia Flyers, have earned a lot of hatred. Some hate Sidney Crosby for his whining attitude and diving. Others hate Chris Letang for being a cheap shot player. But the Penguins just dominate most teams, even if they have to dive and flop like a LeBron James-led team. Number 3, Vancouver Canucks. During their dominant run from 2007 to 2015, was there a team the Canucks didn't develop a rivalry with? They had a historic one with Minnesota and Colorado back in the old Pacific Division days. They and the Flames and Oilers despise each other. The Canucks have had rough times with all 3 California teams, and everyone knows Boston hates them too. Alex Burrows biting Patrice Bergeron's finger in the 2011 final was classless. Maxime LaPierre and Ryan Kessler have been hard for oppositions to deal with over the years as well. Number 2, Toronto Maple Leafs. In Canada, they say that folks from Toronto say they live in the center of the universe. That's a stereotype, of course, but many of their fans seem to dwell on the past. To be precise, their 13 Stanley Cups, with the most recent coming in 1967. Leafs fans are harsh to their own fans, throwing waffles, showing up in paper bags, and running every star player they have out of town. In Canada, no one gets more attention on the news than the entire Leafs organization. Put on a game between Montreal and Ottawa, and the Leafs will be discussed more than Tim Tebow was on ESPN. For their high exposure, most of the Canadian hockey fans outside of Toronto hate the Leafs. And number one, Boston Bruins. Sorry, but when you have Chara, Lucic, and Brad Marchand on your team throughout the years, it's easy to draw hate. They've delivered ugly cheap shots throughout their careers, to say the least. Tuukka Rask is also a huge whiner and always complains. Former goalie Tim Thomas thought he was for skipping a trip to the White House. The Bruins also come from Boston, a city that has some of the most arrogant and obnoxious fans. Plenty of Bruins fans also taunted P.K. Subban and Joel Ward with racial slurs after the two scored playoff overtime goals against them. Lighten up, Boston. Everyone wants to win like you, but we don't want to all be like you. Which NHL team do you hate most? Join us in the comments section below. If you like this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton and we appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around to Total Pro Sports, though, subscribing is a great idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.